So you're in the Final Four for the fifth consecutive time, and you're one of the architects of this success. How does it feel? How does this feeling of success for you?
Well, I've always been thinking that making the Final Four, puts a stamp of excellence on your season. So the fact that we've been able to do it for 5 years in a row is very amazing, because we cannot forget the fact that every season, it's 16 teams, 16 very good organizations, 16 rosters, very, the best quality you may find in Europe, fighting for the same goal that we are fighting for. So once again, it's a very special feeling to be here. Once again, we're fully enjoying this, but we also understand how tough, hard it is to get to this point, and therefore we are enjoying even more. But again, being at the Final Four, it means our season was a very good season.
And Fenerbahce is facing with several injuries of important players actually right now. So do you think Željko Obradović is going to be able to do his magic once again and Fenerbahce is going to win the title?
I think injuries are part of a season for any team. So the best way to prepare for games like this is not to think about the injuries. I have no doubt that coach knows what to do. I have no doubt that the players will be ready to fight. We know what is at stake at this moment. No need to think about what we don't have. There are situations that you can control, situations that you control. We need to worry about what we can control, and we need to be ready. And I have no doubt that coach and the players will be ready for the game tomorrow night.
And Anadolu Efes, after finishing the last season in the last spot of the standings during the regular season, this year they made it out to the playoffs. So were you expecting this success before the beginning of this season?
I don't think anybody expected this turnaround, but that needs to be a compliment to them for this amazing result, because they've turned things around in just a few months. The chemistry on the court was excellent. They played excellent basketball all season. Simple fact that, okay, we led the EuroLeague with our record, but at the end of the day, we played each other six times and ended up being 3-3-3. So the values are very, very close. I think Efes displayed some of the best basketball of EuroLeague this year. So they fully deserve to be here. It's historical for Turkish basketball to have two teams in the final. I hope that this also helps the promotion of the game in Turkey. And then we'll see what happens tomorrow night. But again, we know that we're facing a very, very good team. So we need to be ready.
And my last question. Next year, EuroLeague is even growing with two more teams. So how do you think this will affect the other teams and the schedule of the basketball in Europe?
Well, I don't think four more games are really going to be such a dramatic change. I think EuroLeague growing. I think there is no doubt that every number is confirming the fact that the competition is dramatically growing. So it's getting now a EuroLeague product to great basketball countries and markets like Germany and France, I think, is very significant. But this is the way to go, if you want to grow. So four games in this kind of a season are not going to be that kind of a dramatic factor to manage for. Okay, we all need to focus on a lot of things. We all need to work harder. But I think this is the way to go for the league to be successful.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much for the interview.
Thank you.